Attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello, good evening, everybody. Mothers out there, happy Mother's Day. It's a beautiful day here in Minnesota. So let's start this. Today is the seventh session. We would really like to thank those all of you who have sent Guru Dakshina. Those who have not done so, we request you to please send it. Your support will enable programs like these at reasonable cost. Your support is valuable. Thanks again for those who have sent it. Thanks. Dr. Bhatti, can you please go ahead?
Sure. Thank you. Om Sahanavavatu Sahanobhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu Mavidvishavahai Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Please show the slide. Okay, about this Mantra Pushpanjali, I would like to explain the meaning in the next session. I'm sorry I could not find time to really go through this. So kindly excuse me, but next week I give you a promise that I will explain the meaning of all these verses. So I think we should go to the Subhashitas.
Okay.
तदेवास्य परम मित्रम यत्र संक्रामति द्वयम् दृष्टे सुखम च दुःखम च प्रतिच्छायेव दर्पणे. आर यू श्योर वी हैव नॉट डन दिस लास्ट टाइम?
नो, वी हैव नॉट डन.
ओके. दिस इज अ वेरी गुड डेफिनेशन ऑफ व्हाट अ फ्रेंड इज. एंड एवरीवन नोज अ फ्रेंड in need is a friend indeed. So a friend is like a reflection in a mirror. A reflection in mirror carries all the details of the personality, but here it is more than just a surface image. Tadeva asya param mitram yatra dvayam sankramati. He indeed is his real friend in whom both the things get transferred, sankramati. Which are these two things? Drushte sukham cha dukham cha. After having met or after having seen, drushta, although it literally means having seen, it also further means after having met. So after having met, both the happiness and the sorrow get reflected in the real friend. Drushte sukham cha dukham cha pratichhaya iva darpane, as a reflection in a mirror. So a friend is really he can read the mind of the friend to that extent. To the extent that he can also read all the feelings, including happiness and sorrow. This is what he wants to point out. The glossary, I think, gives all meanings very clearly. If there is any question, there are several other definitions of Mitra also. One thing to be noted is again, which I have already explained. Mitra in neuter means friend. Mitra in masculine means son. I strongly feel we have done this verse. I don't know whether it is here or at some other place.
No, I think you had done, but not in last couple of sessions.
Okay.
Yeah, because that darpane reminded me that, I think it was done long back.
Yes.
Thanks. You have better memory than myself.
I don't think so, but sometimes in subconscious. But since I have been doing these things at a different, at a number of places, sometimes there is a confusion. Fine. So shall we go to the next?
Yeah.
Why did you jump from 82 to 84? There should be 83. This is 82.
No, I think
numbering wrong.
I think, numbering wrong. That's my fault. Sorry about that.
Okay, no problem. Prarabhante alpamevajñah kamam vyagravanti cha maharambhah krutadhiyas tishthanti cha nirakulah. Two different kinds of people, two classes of people in this world are described here. Ajñah alpam eva prarabhante kamam vyagraha bhavanti cha and maharambhah krutadhiyah nirakulah tishthanti cha. So two categories represent ajña and maharambha. There are people who are ignorant, who do not know much about how to proceed. They undertake some task, prarabhante. They start some work, alpam, which is very small, very short. So they start some very insignificant, small work, but because they do not know the procedure, kamam vyagraha bhavanti cha, they get engrossed fully and they tell themselves, oh, I am so busy, I am so busy, I have to teach Subhashitas in this session, I have no time. So whosoever comes and asks any question, he says, no, I have no time because I have to teach 10 Subhashitas next week, so I must prepare. It's a very, very insignificant task, but they just keep themselves fully engrossed and they cannot undertake anything else. Kamam vyagraha bhavanti cha. On the other hand, on the contrary, there are people who are called maharambhaha. They always start great giant undertakings. They are very ambitious people. So very ambitious projects they undertake, they start. But they are krutadhiyaha. They are fully determined people. Krita dhihi yaihi. Those who have made full determination. So those who are fully determined to finish the task, tishthanti cha nirakulaha. They just complete the work, they stay throughout undisturbed, unperturbed. Nirakula. Akula is disturbed, perturbed, confused. So these people, they are so quiet, composed, calm. They just go on doing their work because they are krutadhiyaha. Whereas the other category is represented by ajñas. They are ignorant. They don't know how to. So this is management. Being fully prepared for undertaking a task and just starting something without having any knowledge. Now we have to decide to which category we belong. Ajñas or krutadhis. The glossary I think is okay. Alright, any question?
There was a comment. Yeah. Sorry. Wisdoms give clarity and clarity gives serenity. There was a comment.
Yes, very, very true. Very true.
Yeah. But no.
Very much. Okay. Quite. This comment is quite fitting in this verse. Yeah. Okay. Next one. Khalasarshapamatrani parachidrani pasyati atmano bilva matrani pasyannapina pasyati. So this is a very favorite topic of Subhashitas, to point out the faults in a bad person. And this particular fault, everyone is quite, I mean, aware of it, and we have experienced it quite often. Khalaha, a wicked person, sarshapa matrani parachidrani pasyati. He notices faults in others which are even of the measurement of a sarshapa mustard seed. So even very, very small faults, shortcomings in other person, they are observed by a wicked person. But he cannot see his own faults, which are so obvious, as big as bilwa fruit. Bilwa, I don't know the English word for this, but bilwa, I'm sure each one of you know it. This is a typical sacred Indian tree, which the leaves of which are a favorite of Lord Shiva. Bel, we call it in Marathi. Bilwa matrani. So, you know, the bilwa fruits are, they are quite sizable fruits, quite big. You can certainly see them even from a distance. So even the faults are big enough, they are visible enough. In him, he doesn't see them. But he sees the faults in other persons, which are very, very small. This is the characteristic of a wicked person. Chidranveshi is another word quite often used in Sanskrit. A wicked person is Chidranveshi. He always looks for faults. Fault finding is his very nature. So that is what he wants to emphasize here. I think there is a Marathi proverb which I don't remember at the moment, but it very appropriately fits in this verse.
Oh, आपल्या डोळ्यातलं कुसळ दिसतं पण दुसऱ्याचं मुसळ दिसत नाही.
कुसळ अँड मुसळ. येस, यू सेड इट. येस, थँक्यू, थँक्यू.
बरोबर, दुसऱ्याच्या डोळ्यातलं कुसळ दिसतं पण आपल्या डोळ्यातलं मुसळ दिसत.
आपल्या आपलं मुसळ दिसत नाही. राईट,
थँक्स.
येस, कुसळ आणि मुसळ, सरशप अँड बिल्वा इन दिस वर्स. Okay, any comment?
The comment was like, one was by Nandu, the wood apple tree. I don't know what it means. And the second is the translate Marathi proverb in English. Akshay Shukla was asking. So,
oh, okay. That is your business, Arvind.
Oh, my God.
Okay, I think wood apple tree is, thanks Nandu. I think this is what he has rendered for Bilwa.
Bilwa, okay.
Wood apple.
Mm-hmm.
Appears to be a rendering of bilwa. Because bilwa fruit, yes, it looks like an apple and its color is quite woody.
Oh, that Marathi translation is like you can see a small particle in somebody else's eye. But you cannot see, even if a big
rod
is embedded in your own eyes, that you cannot see, something like that.
Musala is a, I think it's a pestle, huh? Pounding,
yeah.
Instrument. It's a big staff like thing. If Akshay comes from South India, I don't know, but or even in any part of India, in the villages, they use this musala.
They used to smash those rice flakes, rice into flakes or something, right? Poha
exactly,
or something.
Yeah. So it's very big, and as compared to that, this musala is actually a small particle of a straw. Even I mean, you can say so.
Or
there
grain.
Is the similar,
grain.
Yes.
Okay.
So let's hope the translation is properly done. And there may be parallel proverbs also in other Indian languages.
Oh yeah, there is one by Rashmi. We also are saying in Kannada that one finds the hole in another's dosa but can't see the hole in his pan itself.
Very interesting.
Yeah.
Wow. Thank you, Rashmi. Very interesting.
Okay.
quite appropriate, yes. So Kalas have been, you know, taken care of by all communities. Akrodhena jayet krodham, asadhum sadhuna jayet, jayet kadarthan danena, satyenalikavadinam. So this is a Subhashita teaching some kind of ethics, niti, how one should behave in this world. Akrodhena krodham jayet, one should try to win over anger by not being angry, by controlling your anger. Asadhum sadhuna jayet, try to exercise control over bad by goodness, by being kind. And jayet kadartham danena, if you want to win over a miserly person or a miser, just go on giving, giving, giving. And satyena alikavadinam, one who speaks, one who gives lies, always speak truth with him and then you can win over. Well, this is a very, very idealistic, you know, kind of instruction, teaching, which is very similar to what Buddha has been quite often emphasizing in his instructions. But to some extent, you might have experienced also, those who have tried this, that it really carries some meaning. If the person in front of you is very angry and if you just keep quiet and don't respond, I think the temperature comes down. And similarly, if you go on doing good deeds, I think even the wicked person cannot progress further, at least. Similarly, jayet kadartham danena. Miserly person sometimes feels very ashamed of his behavior if he finds a person who is just giving away dana. And satyena alikavadinam. So I think certainly some kind of impact is going to happen on those persons who behave in an improper way if we show the proper way and if we insist on it. This is philosophy of Gandhiji also. It's good, of course, but difficult to practice. Any comment?
No.
Otherwise, the wording is very simple.
Which is okay. Was like, how is alikavadina constructed? Alikavadina.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So, satyena alikavadinam should be first of all split into satyena alikavadinam. So, alika means untruth, lie. Alikam vadati iti alikavadin. One who speaks, how should you say, untruth?
Lies.
One who if we say one who speaks, what will be the next word? One who speaks untruth or apan kaya manto khota. So is there any word for khota in English? Lie. One who speaks lies.
Yeah.
Alika. Alika is untruth. But I really don't know the exact English word for asatya. Untruth is a negative of truth.
Yes.
But what is a positive? Yes. So alika vadinam means one who speaks, or one who gives lies or one who speaks lies.
Or false. Maybe.
Ah, yeah, false. But doesn't
false is not exact,
mean,
yeah.
Yeah, it means wrong.
Yeah, it is like true false. And false. Yeah.
True and false. Okay. Okay. For the time being, Allah is the only word which I remember. But if anyone can suggest any better, is most welcome. Okay, any comment?
No comment.
But we should try to imbibe this Subhashita on our mind and try to follow. Okay. न पृष्टः कस्यचित् ब्रूयात् न चान्यायेन पृच्छतः जानन्नपि हि मेधावी जडवल्लोकाचरेत्. सो दिस इज अबाउट हाउ वन शुड स्पीक इन दिस वर्ल्ड. अपृष्टः कस्यचित् न ब्रूयात्. न पृष्टः इज अ संधि, न अपृष्टः. अपृष्टः कस्यचित् न ब्रूयात्. One should not talk to anyone unless one is asked. Aprushtaha, not asked. Prushtaha means asked. So unless you are asked to speak, you don't speak at all. This is the advice of this poet. Nacha anyayena pruchyataha. One should neither speak when he is not asked, nor he should speak when someone asks in an improper way. Nacha anyayena pruchyataha. So if someone asks you in a proper way, then only speak. And then in the next line he says, medhavi, an intelligent person, a wise person, jananapi loke jadavat acharit. Although he knows many things, janan, although he is a knower, although he is quite well versed, he should behave in this world, acharit loke jadavat, as if he is ignorant. So always try to keep quiet. Don't go on talking unless you are asked to talk, unless you are asked to give some information. Even if you know many things, very difficult for women to follow, I am sure, because it is in their very nature to speak. So there are quite a few Subhashitas which give you advice on how to speak, where to speak, what not to speak, and so on and so forth. So this one tells you, keep quiet. Don't speak unless there is an occasion, there is a proper occasion, and unless you are properly approached to speak. This is a characteristic of a wise person. He always keeps quiet. This is a characteristic of maturity. Mature people, they are always very quiet and composed, particularly in assemblies. Okay?
Yeah, there are comments like, wise man speaks because he has something to say. A fool speaks yes. because he has to keep saying something.
Yes.
And another comment was like, this is excellent advice in corporate meetings.
Yes. Just keep quiet unless you are asked to say something.
Yes.
But you know.
Sorry. Yeah. Good.
There is another verse which says a fool or an ignorant person should always keep quiet in assemblies, because that is a very good, kind of a cover of your ignorance. Vibhushanam maunam apanditanam. So, your being quiet can be interpreted into exactly opposite ways. Either you are very intelligent and you don't want to spare your words, or because you are quite ignorant and therefore you just shut up. Subhashitas, they are very funny, you know.
There is a question like, is it Jadava Lok or Jadava Loke? Loke is seventh this thing, right?
Yes, it is Jadavat. Actually, this compound has been, this sandhi has been shown in the glossary, Jadavat Loke. Loke is a locative of Loka, and it means in the world. Loka means world, and Loke, locative, means in the world. Here in the verse, you don't find Loke, and you find Loka, because of sandhi rule. This A is dropped because it is followed by a vowel.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah. So this is a typical sandhi rule.
Okay.
Yes.
And there was a comment. Isn't there a Subhashit ending with Maunam Sarvartha Sadhanam?
Oh, yes. Yes. So for Mauna, there are quite a few Subhashitas. And Maunam Sammati Lakshanam is also yet another. So Mauna can, as I told you, it can be interpreted in a number of ways. So one has really to decide when to keep Mauna and when to speak. Maunam Sammati Lakshanam, if you just keep quiet, it means that you accept what is being spoken in front of you. Maunam Sarvartha Sadhanam, yes. Just keep quiet and you get all your purpose served. Various meanings of Mauna. So, hats off to these Subhashitakaras. They could find all these nuances of Mauna. Right. Jada means ignorant. Jada. Jada literally means heavy. Apan Marathi jad manto. Okay. Any?
Okay.
If there is any other comment.
No, another was that Maunina Kalaho Nasti.
Yes. Maunina Kalaho Nasti. I think we have seen, we have read this Subhashita perhaps in one of the previous sessions. So there is no kalaha. If you keep quiet, well, no possibility of fight, because for fight, two mouths have to keep on talking. Apan Marathit manto na don bhandi ekatra ali ki ti vastat. Ek bhanda baju chakat nahi. So if one person goes on speaking, no fight, no battle, no verbal, of course, fight is possible. Maunina kalaho nasti. Yeah. Next.
There is one more comment, one more question, like how does that Subhashita go? Like Maunam Sarvartha Sadhanam, so you said it's at the end, so can you please elaborate or do you recall the whole Subhashita?
Maunam Sarvartha Sadhanam, no, I will I just cannot recall it at this moment, but I will give you next week, okay? And Maunina Kalaho Nasti, I think we have done it earlier. Maunam Sarvartha Sadhanam. No, I will have to remember it. I will have to find out.
Oh, there was one more comment, like in some situations silence speaks 1,000 words.
Yes, certainly. Silence sometimes is the most eloquent. They say silence is eloquent. Sometimes it is most eloquent than speech. Yes, right. So we can write an essay on Mauna, isn't it?
Yeah.
Which was practiced by Mahatma Gandhi. And what did his Mauna convey?
Here even that criminal is told you have the right to remain silent.
Yes. Yeah.
I think there are many comments but not questions, so we can go to the next one.
Okay. Yadevopanatam dukhat sukham tadrasavattaram nirvanaya taruchaya taptasya hi visheshataha. So whatever happiness we experience after having experienced sorrow, it leads to more happiness. It is, you know, more appealing. Yad eva upanatam, yad eva sukham dukkhat upanatam tad rasavattaram. Whatever happiness, yad eva sukham dukkhat upanatam, means dukkhat anantaram upanatam, which approaches you after unhappiness, after misery, after pain. Tad rasavat taram, it is more. Tara means more. It's a comparative suffix. Rasavat taram, it is more tasty. Literally, it is more pleasing. So happiness after experiencing misery is more appealing, more pleasing. And then he gives an illustration. Taruchaya tap तस्य हि विशेषतः निर्माणाय शैडो ऑफ अ ट्री इट मेक्स अ पर्सन हु इज हीटेड बाय और स्क्वाश्ड बाय द हीट ऑफ द सन इट इज मोर अपीलिंग मोर कूल सो इफ यू अप्रोच अ ट्री आफ्टर हैविंग वॉक्ड फॉर माइल्स इन हॉट सन देन इट इज मोर कूलिंग दिस इज वॉट ही सेज And there is another Subhashita which gives a similar meaning. Sukham hi dukkhan yanubhuya shobhate. Sukham hi dukkhan yanubhuya shobhate. Ghanandhakare shvivadipa darshanam. I think perhaps we have done this verse also last time. Ghanandhakare shu dipa darshanam iva sukham dukkhani anubhuya shobhate. So after After a long darkness, if you find a small lamp, if you find just a bit of happiness after a long period of unhappiness, it is more appealing. This is what he wants to say. Nirvana has many meanings actually in Buddhism. Nirvana means the last state one should try to achieve. Quietude. My pronunciation may be wrong, but it is the state of quietness, nirvana, when the lamp is extinguished, the lamp of life is extinguished and there is just calmness spread all over, nirvana. And nirvana also means comfort, happiness, but that actually implies a calmness. Nirvana deepaha, the lamp has been extinguished. This is a basic meaning. So you do experience some kind of calmness, and it is more after you have experienced heat. This is the meaning. Okay, any question, any comment?
Or somebody came, a couple of people suggested that the shloka initially was Atmanas mukha dosheṇa badyante sukasarika baka tatra na badyante maunam sarvartha sadhanam.
Fine, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Rashmi and Nandu, right. Both. Yeah.
Yes. So I don't need to explain the meaning since they have found it out properly. Atmanu mukha dosheṇa badyante sukha sarikāḥ. It is their own fault. Sukha and sarikas. They are put in cage. Yeah. So it is better the parrots don't how will you say? Twitter? And sarikāḥ. They don't sing. Right. Thank you, Nandu. Thank you, Rashmi. So we have in our gathering well-versed people, huh? In Subhashitas. Very good.
Yeah, people are knowledgeable here. The audience is great.
Yeah.
Their participation also is great.
Right. I am really very happy. So perhaps they can take up the next sessions. I'm sure.
There is an emphatic no.
Why? Nandu's site is really very rich and it is enriched by my friend, I know, Kolatkar, who is a great scholar. So you have good people, good teachers and knowledgeable people at home. Okay.
Next.
Shall you go to this next one?
Yeah.
Okay. Anukule vidhau deyam yatah purayita harihi pratikule vidhau deyam yatah sarvam harishyati. So deyam. One should go on giving. One should go on giving even when one can't afford and even when one affords. This is the message. I think perhaps. In one of my last sessions, I said, Kalau Danam Vishishyate. All these Dharma Shastrakaras, they say that the best thing to do in this Kali Yuga is Dana. Dana has quite often been emphasized in Kali Yuga. One should always try to give away and accumulate merit. So he says, Anukule Vidhau Deyam. When the fortune is quite favorable, when you are very, very lucky, you should go on giving, because there is this Hari in the heaven, the Lord, who will just go on filling your empty baskets. Go on giving and he will fill up. Like Shri Krishna helping Draupadi at the time of Draupadi Vastra Harana. You know, go on giving, go on, go on, go on. Yatah Purayita Hari, because Vidhi is Anukula. The fate is in your favor. You are fortunate. So you are sure to get things from God. And when the fate is pratikula, even then one should try to give, because finally nothing is going to remain with you. Yataha sarvam harishyati. The God who is the giver, he himself is going to carry away everything from you. When you will die, you will not be able to carry anything with you. Sarvam harishyati. So what's the point in keeping things with me if I am going to die without carrying anything with me in the next life? Pratikule api vidhudeyam, anukule api vidhudeyam. Very wise, you know, advice and good logic behind this, I think. Okay, very simple wording. Yataha means because. Sarvam harishyati has Harihi as the agent. Harihi sarvam harishyati. And Hari means, Hari, although it's an epithet of Vishnu, it is one of the, of course, names of Vishnu listed in Vishnu Sahasranama. Hari here stands for any god, God in general.
There was one comment.
Please,
here, most of the time giving we think is always money, but actually it can be knowledge also, right?
Everything, whatever you can give is just dana. It's not just money. Certainly knowledge, everything you should give. When he says deyam, whatever you can give, you just give it. You give knowledge, you give money, you give clothes, you give utensils, whatever one asks for and one is needy, you should try to give him. And whatever, of course, you can afford. And you know, Dehadana, Netradana, and all these danas are also very highly praised. Even you can give even after you die. You can give your own body. So all that is included in Deyam. But there are, you know, some very shrewd people who give only that which they don't want, which they don't want to possess. So we give worn clothes, we give utensils which we no more use. So all junk things we give and we try to accumulate merit. Next one. Parokshe karyahantaram pratyakshe priyavadinam varjayet tadrusham mitram vishakumbham payomukham. So a mitra can be something like this. So we should be very cautious. Parokshe karyahantaram and pratyakshe priyavadinam. There are some friends who speak very sweet in front of you, but before, after you, parokshe, in your absence, karyahantaram, they just destroy your work. Because they are not your real friends, they are your enemies. Parokshe karyahantaram, one who destroys your work, whatever you have undertaken, the purpose, and those who speak very sweet, very pleasant in front of you, just abandon them. Varjayet, one should try to abandon, give up. Tadrusham, that kind of friend. And then there is an analogy. Vishakumbham payomukham. It is like a pot full of poison with milk only on surface. So don't trust the face, don't trust what is on the surface. But it is sometimes very difficult to, you know, discover, difficult to understand that a person standing in front of you is not your friend but your enemy. It takes time to judge, isn't it? Any comment?
No comment on this.
We have been, I think, experiencing these things.
Is tadrusha also a sandhi?
No. Tadrusha is a word by itself. Tadrusha. Saha eva drushyate iti tadrusha. So one who looks like that. It is a compound and not a sandhi.
Amar, go ahead.
Karyam hanti iti karya hanta. This is also a compound. Karyam hanti, literally killer of work. So he undoes what you have done, or he tries to put some obstacles in your work. This so-called friend.
Is it samas? Is it samas?
Tadrusha, yes. It is a samasa, it is a upapada tatpurush. Saha iva drushyate iti tadrushaha. Or tat iva drushyate tadrushaha. That which looks like that, similar to that, of that kind, like that. This is the meaning of tadrusha. Tadrusha, etadrusha, sadrusha, these are all compounds. And we have another, you know, group of words, tadruk, sadruk, etadruk, from the same, you know, pair of words.
Then there is a question like, this Suvashita is for a friend, anything for an enemy, but...
I think this Suvashita works for both, enemy and friend. But yes, there are many Subhashitas for enemy also. Well, I will have to stretch my memory. But let's see if I can find next time.
Okay.
Aho gunanam praptyartham yatante bahudha naraha. मुक्ता यदर्थं भग्ना स्याः इतरेषां च का कथा. अहो इज अ इंडिक्लाइनेबल विच कन्वेज सरप्राइज. ओ इट्स सो वंडरफुल. ओ इट इज सरप्राइजिंग. दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अहो. अहो गुणानां प्राप्त्यर्थं नराः बहुधा यतन्ते. Oh, this is a surprise. People strive in a variety of ways in order to obtain qualities, virtue. Gunanam praptyartham naraha bahudha yatante. So many efforts they undertake. Yadartham muktaha bhaganasyaha. For the obtainment of guna, even the pearls had to get their mouths broken. So guna is a word used with a pun here. Guna means two things, quality and thread. So if you want to put thread through the pearl, it needs a hole. So that hole can be made into a pearl by breaking its mouth. So even for a pearl, it is necessary to break its own mouth in order to get the quality through it. Muktaha yadartham, for the sake of which, is the literal meaning. Yad artham. Bhagna asya. Asya is mouth. So the mouth of the pearl is broken so that one can pass the thread. Actually, both the sides. You cannot just break only one side. So we have to say that the pearl has two mouths, two ends, and they are broken. Itaresham chaka katha, what to say of others? Even a valuable gem like a pearl has to get its both the mouths broken in order to pass the qualities through. What to say about others? Itaresham ka katha. Okay?
Yeah.
Translation has actually given this as a question. How many efforts are put in by people to acquire qualities? It means the same. But the way I explained also is correct. And mukta also has a pun here. Mukta means an emancipated soul. Muktaha. Those who have emancipated themselves by, you know, dhyana, dharana, sadhana, samadhi, etc. Even they are required to break their mouths. This is a pun actually. Breaking mouth is true of pearls and not of emancipated souls. But the poet wants to use it as a word with a pun.
Yeah, somebody has asked, if Rashmi asked, like, is it breaking of pearl shell or the pearl itself? I think if you have to go put a thread through it, then it has to be through the pearl itself, right?
Yes, you have to pierce through. Well, I am not much well versed in the science of gemology, but I don't think pearls, they are, when they are created within the shells, they carry the hole by themselves. They need to be pierced, I think.
Hmm.
Amar, can you say anything about this? Because yeah, you belong to a family of jewelers.
No.
You get ready pearls and ready pearl ornaments. Hmm? Already made. Made to order. But I think common sense tells us, I don't know, common sense tells us that pearls, they need to be pierced. Okay, next one. Gunair gauravama ayati nochai rasanama sthitaha prasada shikharasthopi kakona garudayate. Yes, one correction needs to be in the text of the verse. Gunair gauravama ayati. This gau should contain refa, which is absent here. I'm sorry. I failed to notice it earlier. But it should be gunair gaurava mayati. Visarga transformed into ra, which is shown by a little curve above, by the side of this au sign, two matras. It should be gunair gauravam ayati na uchaihi asanam asthita. So one acquires greatness only by means of qualities and virtues and not by just sitting on a high seat. So your chair doesn't really give you the greatness which you are aspiring for. Prasada shikharasthopi kakaha na garudayate. It's very clear. A crow sitting on the top of her palace doesn't become. So it's not the place that gives you greatness. It's your own contribution. काय म्हणायचं त्याला, तुमचं कर्तृत्व, युअर अचीवमेंट्स विच मेक यू ग्रेट. सो जस्ट सिटिंग इन द चेअर ऑफ अ डायरेक्टर डझंट मेक अ पर्सन रिअली ग्रेट. गुणैः गौरवम् आयाति न उच्चैः आसनम् आस्थितः. दिस इज हाउ वी शुड स्प्लिट दीज संधीज. प्रासाद शिखरस्थः अपि काकः न गरुडायते. अ व्हेरी स्ट्रेंज वर्ब यू विल सी हियर, गरुडायते. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड अ नाम धातु. इवन यू नो फ्रॉम नाउन्स यू कैन मेक वर्ड्स इन संस्कृत एंड ऑल्सो इन मराठी, पर्टिक्युलरली इन ज्ञानेश्वरी. आय डोंट नीड टू टेल दिस टू अरविंद जी. बैल दुभवी नंदाघरी, मिल्किंग. वॉट इज दिस मिल्किंग? मिल्क एंड टू मिल्क, द नाउन इट सेल्फ बिकम्स अ वर्ब. सो ऑल द नाउन्स इन संस्कृत दे कैन जस्ट ट्रांसफॉर्म themselves into words. Garudayate means garuda iva acharati, behaves like a garuda. Similarly you can say garuda na kakayate, a garuda doesn't become a kaka. Trushnayate, krushnayate, very very common use of nouns as verbs found in Sanskrit literature. Prasada shikharastha also is a compound. Prasadasya shikharam, prasada shikharam, prasada shikhare tishthati prasada shikharastha, one who stands, rests on the top of a prasada.
Palace.
Prasada is a multi-storied building, a skyscraper, whatever you call it.
Or palace or something.
Yes, palace also.
Yeah, somebody has given an equivalence, like Rashmi said, don't be carried away by the titles, they don't have much bearing when it comes to the true excellence. The true excellence, excellent people do not even care for the name of their designation.
Precisely, yes, you said it, Rashmi. That's right. Greatness lies not in your
nations.
Yes, your position. It lies in your activity, your contribution, your achievements. Yeah. So these Subhashitas, you know, if they are imbibed in the minds of our children, right from the childhood, I think we can certainly expect a better future. Don't we? There is a school of thinkers. And I recently met a group of NRIs in Pune who feel that Subhashitas can teach lot of wisdom. So teaching Sanskrit and wisdom through Subhashitas is the best way, they say, because then you can achieve two purposes.
That's very correct, very true.
Yeah. And there are, you know, thousands of them, about 15,000 Subhashitas. The whole life you can go on reading and studying them. In fact, it is worth undertaking this project of compiling, collecting all the Subhashitas and translating them in good English and other regional languages. Some efforts have already been made in this direction. Sorry to say, not by Indians but by foreigners. But now Indians have also started, feeling about the Subhashitas.
I think Indians will do it when it is outsourced to them.
I don't know. Do you want to include me in that category? Am I outsourced?
No, I'm just kidding.
Okay.
That there is a website given by Rashmi, like sanskritpearls.blogspot.com.
Yeah.
There okay. Maybe we have some Subhashitas collected there.
Yes, I have also come across some Subhashitas, and I am also actually translating some Subhashitas for a website, which may come up sometime when I finish the work, of course.
Mm-hmm. And I think that is by Rashmi herself.
Dharma Rashmi herself.
Yeah, sanskritpearls.blogspot.com.
Oh, good. Rashmi, congrats. And yes, my compliments to you. Very good, excellent. Go ahead and go on adding also to these pearls. There is an infinite number of pearls in this sea of Sanskrit literature.
Dr. Bhatre, do you have your website or somewhere where you are adding these things?
No, I am a very lazy person as far as this, you know, digital knowledge bank is concerned. And actually I have no time to create such. Mm-hmm. But there are people who want me to, you know, as you have done it. A couple of other people also, my friends. So eventually it may come up, but I haven't done it so far. I would certainly like to do that. Maybe it would be wise to actually prepare a CD, because Subhashitas, they are also to be listened to. Sanskrit is not meant only for being read. Sanskrit has its sonority. You know, that is one of the very striking features of Sanskrit language. So it needs to be recited properly, and then only it can really appeal to your heart. So we should have an audio CD of Subhashitas. And I don't know if anyone would like to undertake this as a project.
You know, we can also read that Sanskrit, but when uh-huh. you say it, that gives a wonderful flavor to it, and we just like it like nothing else, you know.
Oh, thank you very much. Thanks for your compliments. But, you know, thanks to my, you know, family background, and thanks to all my teachers who taught me, my parents, my father and my uncle who taught me right from my childhood when I was 3 years old. They just taught me Ramaraksha and other things. So this is how I could develop,
aptitude,
a practice of recitation.
Yeah, because just reading doesn't convey the same meaning, even if the meaning is printed there. But when you see it, perhaps then we don't have to look down at the meaning. When you say it in a particular way, we get the meaning automatically somehow.
Thank you, Arvind.
Thanks.
So this is going to be a good day for me.
Oh, no.
Thanks a lot.
And also, I think we would put that link from Rashmi in the newsletter. And also, I think sanskritdocument.org, it also has a good list of Subhashitas. So we will also include that link also.
Yes, sure. Certainly, that will be very helpful. Very nice.
And there was a suggestion like translation should not be done word to word, but in a way more like easy to understand by NRIs born.
Okay. Well, there are two ways of translating, because, you know, this is one suggestion, but there was another suggestion that try to make it as faithful to the verse as possible. So if you have to be faithful to the wording of the verse, then it has to be literal. So actually we have to strike a golden mean.
Like when I agree. 11th grade and 10th grade in good old times, mm-hmm. those days the teachers would give us literal meaning and then a more liberal kind of meaning in Marathi, you know.
Free rendering. Yes, that is also required. You are right,
Thanks.
Okay. Is time up?
Yeah, okay. Actually, yes, I think we should stop here.
We can take this last one perhaps, or what do you think?
It's already 9:30, so.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so next week we begin with Mantra Pushpanjali.
Okay.
Next.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah,
it's okay.
We would, I don't know whether we could include that in the next thing because we have lined up our Subhashitas, but let's see how that goes next time. Perhaps we could do it a little bit longer because it would be the last time we would be meeting up for this Subhashita goes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can we have it a bit open-ended up to say 10 or 15 minutes overflow?
Yeah, that should be fine, I think, next time.
Next time, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, thank you, everybody. Thanks for joining today. Once again, I request you to send Guru Dakshina whatever amount that's visible for you. Thanks, and next time would be last one. Also, if you have any requests, like we were planning to have Dr. Bhatia has agreed to present the whatever Sanskrit old epics there are. So she has agreed to present them, so we can line that up. If you have any suggestions, send us an email on sanskrit.forum@gmail.com. We'll be doing those. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.